In this video, you will learn how to implement the parameter optimization loop in the KNIME analytics platform. Let's jump in. The goal of using a parameter optimization loop is to find the best set of parameters for your prediction model. Like all other loops, the parameter optimization loop follows the classic KNIME loop motif, which includes a loop body located between the loop start node and the loop end node. To perform parameter optimization, you use the parameter optimization loop start and parameter optimization loop end nodes. These two nodes surround the loop body where you train the prediction model. The parameter optimization loop start node iterates through a list of parameter sets, applying a new set of parameters to the learner node at each iteration. The parameter optimization loop end node collects these iteration results and compares them to the previous one. Let's start with a pre-prepared workflow that reads a data set, splits it into a training set and a test set using the partitioning node, trains a classification model with the decision tree learner node, applies the model to the test data set using the decision tree predictor node, and uses a scorer node to calculate the accuracy and evaluate the model's performance. Our goal is to find the set of parameters for the decision tree learner algorithm that leads to the highest accuracy on the test set. First, look at the configuration window of the decision tree learner node to identify which settings can be optimized. In this example, we will optimize the minimum number of records per node setting. The aim is to find the optimal value for this setting that leads to the highest accuracy. To build the loop, you need the parameter optimization loop start and end nodes. You find these nodes in a node repository and drag and drop the start node into the workflow editor. This node has only one output port of type flow variable. In the configuration window, you can add a parameter by clicking the Add New Parameter button. Define the parameter name, start value, stop value, and step size. For example, you can create a new parameter named min number of records with a start value of 2, a stop value of 15, and a step size of 1. You can add more parameters if needed. You can choose between two search strategies, brute force or hill climbing. The brute force strategy checks all possible parameter combinations and returns the best one, meaning it will train a model for each value between 2 and 15 in our example. The hill climbing strategy requires less computational effort as it starts with a random set and proceeds with only the direct neighbor values according to the given intervals and step sizes. The best value combination among all neighbor values becomes the starting point for the next iteration. If no neighbor improves the accuracy, the loop terminates. After executing the start node, you see that you get one flow variable with our defined parameter name and the start value of 2. You need to overwrite the original setting in the decision tree learner node with the parameter value produced by the parameter optimization loop start node. You connect the flow variable output port of the start node to the flow variable input port of the decision tree learner node, injecting the flow variable into the learner node. In the learner node's configuration window, under the flow variables tab, you find the setting for the minimum number of records and overwrite its value with the flow variable. Next, drag and drop the parameter optimization loop end node into the workflow editor. In the configuration window, set the flow variable for the objective function value and specify whether you want to maximize or minimize it. Use the accuracy value from the scorer node as the objective function. Connect the flow variable output port of the scorer node to the flow variable input port of the loop end node. In the configuration window, you choose accuracy as the flow variable containing the objective function value. Select to maximize the function and press OK. When we execute the parameter optimization loop end node, the whole loop is executed. With the brute force strategy selected, the model is trained for each parameter value between 2 and 15. Once the loop execution is complete, you can examine the resulting tables. The table at the first output port gives us the parameter set corresponding to the highest accuracy, while the second output table provides the accuracy for all tested parameters. In this video, you have learned how to implement a parameter optimization loop in KNIME. Configure the decision tree learner node for parameter optimization. Use the parameter optimization loop start and end nodes to optimize model parameters. Choose between brute force and hill climbing optimization strategies. Connect floor variables to dramatically adjust parameters during loop execution. Analyze the results to identify the optimal parameter set.